про ситуацію на сході України у зоні проведення.
About the situation in the two area, the update is provided by Colonel Lysenko, Minister of Defense of Ukraine. Good news is that during yesterday, there were no losses among Ukrainian military men, although there were 21 shellings. In Luhansk sector, the situation calmed down. Russian occupational troops conducted one armed provocation in Novoalexandrivka, and they also shelled Troitsk with grenade launchers. Both cases of ceasefire violation were in the evening, and they were not longer than 1 hour. In Donetsk sector, the new day started with the nighttime shelling in Avdiivka. The enemy opened fire of small arms in the daytime. In the midday time, the provocations started again, and the enemy twice opened mortar fire in Avdiivka. Yet another mortar shelling took place in Verkhnoye-Tarevskoye. In Pisky, the occupants used grenade launchers in the area of Svitlodar Salient. The situation was calm yesterday. Yesterday, in Donetsk sector, there were five ceasefire violations, including three with the use of mortars. In Mariupol sector, the situation has not changed. The main areas of armed conflict are Marienka, Pavlopil, Shirokine sector of frontline. In Marienka, the fire was opened by hostile snipers in the evening many times. The militants used grenade launchers and infantry fighting vehicle arms. As a result of hostile shelling in Marienka, several buildings were damaged. Also, our checkpoint Marienka in Donetsk-Zaporizhia Highway was shelled on. One civilian was injured. In Shirokina, Russian occupants once opened fire of self-propelled Grad Partisan installation. In Krasnogorivka, the militants shelled with grenade launchers. Last day, in Mariupol sector, there were 14 militants provocations. Ukrainian military intelligence found information about the intentions of the enemy to organize next intern information provocation against Ukrainian troops. The militants plan to organize a fake clash near Novogrigorivka. This is planned to organize for Russian propaganda, and it is related to the incident which took place on April 23rd in Luhansk region, when one OSCE mission staff member died. The enemy has not stopped its attempts to conceal their crimes and systematical violations of Minsk accords. They want to demonstrate as if Ukrainian armed forces are guilty in this tragedy. Ukrainian policemen detained in Bakhmut, yet another member of hostile subversive group. The expert assessment established that there were eight automatic guns of the first arsenal of saboteurs. They were stolen from Ukrainian military units in Crimea in spring 2014. In the field artillery storage of the armed forces of Ukraine in Lugansk, the first training started how to correctly store shells and other ammunition. Not only theory, but also practical training are conducted on how to store the ammunition, how to protect the military storages and warehouses, how to extinguish training fires, 10 armored vehicles and special vehicles were used. In Kharkiv region, military men of National Guard of Ukraine carried out training fire exercises using Zu-23 installations. The military men with the systems trained in the firing ground where they use counter ear devices. That's all information for now. Thank you very much for your information, Mr. Colonel. Thank you. The next briefing about the situation in NTO area will be tomorrow at 12:30. Thank you.